Hundreds of thousands of us use New York City subways. Let's say millions. What kind of bacteria is riding along with you, though? We sent CBS 2's Christine Sloan out with some volunteers and scientists who are doing some subway swabbing.
Turnstiles and inside subway trains. Riders say they're always on the lookout for germs riding along with them.
I try not to touch things on the train.
A team of biologists from Weill Cornell Medicine, led by Dr. Chris Mason, curious what's down in the subway, taking nylon swabs of benches, turnstiles, railings, and seats on trains.
Where did you find most of the bacteria? Were there on seats or railings?
The place where we got the most DNA and the most diversity of life was actually on wooden seats, and so it's actually we see less on steel surfaces.
Mason swabbing, part of a global antimicrobial resistance study.
Actually, bacteria in the subway could help you find new drugs?
That's right. So bacteria actually make antibiotics to compete with each other, so we can grab them and actually discover what they're making.
So if you're worried about touching things on the train or in the subway, don't. Mason says there's actually more bacteria on your hand than there is on this railing or on a seat.
We can unequivocally say that you don't need to wear gloves. It's actually very safe in the subway, that it's basically just like shaking hands with someone when you walk on the street.
More than 8,000 samples will be taken from the subway by the end of the day, all of it logged in a mobile device app to see what kind of bacteria lurks in different cities. On the Upper East Side, Christine Sloan, CBS 2 News.
The Gates Foundation funded the study. The results should be out in the fall.